how do you feel about AI at work? Do you feel AI is your companion, or do you feel it's more of an intruder? Who feels it's a companion? Who feels AI is more of an intruder? Yeah, I see some hands up. So if you feel AI is more of an intruder, and if you have that eerie feeling in the back of your head, then there might be a good reason. And let me explain why. First, to start with, a fact. Human brain is actually a computer. It's a computer just built on a carbon carrier, not a silicon carrier. And to explain, there are many fundamental similarities and conceptual similarities between the way our brains are built and function and AI functions. In principle, a brain is a Bayesian machine that takes stimuli from the environment and then builds a model of an external world. And then whenever there is a new stimulus or a query, it produces some probabilistic output given that model of the world. And that's also what LLMs are doing in principle. The main difference between the brain and LLMs is that we have sensory systems and we can actively interact with the environment and we can test causal interactions in the real world. So we can interact, and LLMs at this moment are not able to do that yet. And actually, some of the components of AI systems used in use today are directly imported from the brain. As an example, convolutional neural networks used for image recognition are copy-pasted from the brain as we know it, and they work very similarly and accurately. Yes, we are very similar, or maybe in another way, AI is very similar to our brain. For more, AI has learning models that actually are faster than learning in a human brain. So the way we learn is it's called Hebbian learning. So it happens at the synapses. What fires together wires together. When two neurons are involved in the same synaptic, in the same cognitive process, they happen to often fire together, and then the synaptic connection between them gets stronger. And this type of learning is slow, is stochastic, and it's local. Versus AI can learn much faster. It can learn via backpropagation, and it can update its weights every single time a new stimulus is presented, and it can be global, fast, and noiseless. Human skull is isolated system, so we have limited opportunities to grow our brains, versus AI systems can be arbitrarily augmented by more computing power. Productivity induced by AI is growing very fast. It's actually even faster than exponential growth. And no wonder that actually AI becomes a competition to human knowledge work. It caused a disturbance to the job market, and especially in the class of jobs and professions that are somewhere in between physical work and highly specialized knowledge work. So somewhere in the middle of the spectrum, they actually started replacing human workers, and the jaws are spreading. So indeed, in a way, AI became an intruder in the job market, and it disturbed the global job market. And let me share an observation. So the global job market is a dynamical system. And in a way, it is beautiful because we are all connected in a way, via tax system, via job contracts, via relations with our coworkers, with our employers, with our clients. So it's a beautiful system, ecosystem, hashtag Alan Watts. But the downside is that if there is any disturbance in this global ecosystem, we all, as a ripple effect, we all feel the consequences. And what happens if you disturb a dynamical system? Two things can happen. It can either go back to original state of balance, or it can jump to quite a new state of balance that could be fundamentally different in dynamics than the previous one. And these state transitions often happen in a result of so-called black swan events, so global unprecedented events like, let's say, COVID-19 or any other unprecedented event of a global relevance like this. The last time we experienced a major state transition in the job market was in the Industrial Revolution. Before the Industrial Revolution, the physical work was the dominant way we used to deliver labor, right? And then via a series of breakthrough discoveries and inventions in science and technology, the job market fundamentally changed, and the new class of jobs was created. The jobs as we know it, known as knowledge jobs, and the new law, labor law, was also created. So the job market changed forever. And now what we experience is the AI revolution. The question is, are we going to transition to the new state of balance? Yes or no, because it might go two ways. So one scenario is, yes, we go back. Well, we have unemployment right now caused by AI, but people upskill and adapt. Maybe we become more of cyborgs. Maybe we adapt some bionic elements and augment our cognitive skills with machines. Or maybe there is a new class of jobs that is more based on relations and connections, and maybe it becomes a new standard to hire a professional and a personal chef and personal gardener, and we all base our labor more on connections with others. Who knows? But I have a question for you, which is, do you know this turtle? Do you know what was it famous for? His name is Harriet. She's deceased, unfortunately, but she got world famous. And does anyone know? So she was Charles Darwin's pet. Charles Darwin, yeah. He found her in the islands of Galapagos in 1835, and he adopted her. They became lifelong friends, although it was lifelong only for Charles because she outlived him by a century. And she made him like think a lot about evolution. And he basically concluded via interactions with creatures like her that you don't have to be the biggest, the smartest, and the strongest animal to survive. You just have to be different, find your biological niche, and occupy that niche, and the evolution will give you a chance. And the second scenario, perhaps we go through a big state transition in the job market. Perhaps there is no way back. Perhaps the new job market will be a job market of universal basic income that can happen in many forms. For instance, like three examples, some monthly allowance, or as universal basic services, or maybe in some other form of supporting us. But we don't know. So the thing is, we don't know what the future brings. So what do we do when we don't know if it's gonna rain or not? I know it's an abstract problem for you Californians, but like, just let's imagine that there is a non-zero probability of rain. What do we do? Nobody knows? Well, we get an umbrella. It exists, believe me. What is umbrella for us as professionals? Well, umbrella is our knowledge, right? It's the way we adapt, the way we learn, the way we improve. We have to be like Harriet. We have to adapt. The question is what to learn, right? What to learn in 2025 to actually be on top of our game? It's a hard problem. But what if I told you that this problem was already solved? Not decades, not centuries, but actually thousands of years ago. And in antiquity, in ancient Greece, what noblemen from higher class were doing were not teaching their kids how to farm or how to ride a horse. That was for the peasants. For the higher class, they were teaching their kids so-called liberal arts that were supposed to lead to independence as an adult. They were meant for kids that were supposed to be politicians, supposed to be scholars or property owners. And how to translate those liberal arts to our reality, right, 2025? Well, so actually it's possible, so it seems. And last year there was a very interesting discussion that started on Platform X by Devon Erickson, who proposed his own translation of those liberal arts into our reality. And I couldn't agree more. I think it was spot on what he proposed. And I very much like the fact that, yeah, it's actually updated for our reality where we coexist with machines in the job market. What I particularly like about this list is the agency part, because I work with professionals and agency is the most missing skill right now. Just one more thing before we finish this talk. Going back to the possible scenarios for the future, we have two scenarios, right? We have a scenario of a rain when we still have to compete with others in the job market. We have to upskill and repurpose our careers. In this scenario, if we learn the modern liberal arts, we are on top of our game and we win. If the other scenario plays out and we don't have to work anymore and worry anymore, well, at least we become smarter and more emotionally developed, so we win anyways. So it's a win-win. Let's live our best professional lives. Thank you, guys.